Hi, this is Sherry Methling with Ancient Healings Around the World. I'm here at the Lindisfarne Priory, built around the 11th century, between 1125 to 1150. This is the remains. It's an island, about 15 minutes outside of Berwick. Into the energy of this priory. I saw the priory from the castle, the Lindisfarne castle. And I knew I was supposed to do video of here once again. I'm always drawn to the abbeys, to the priories. And then I asked the land, I asked the energies within me and around me, what should I talk about? I didn't receive an answer. So I just thought to walk you through the priory here, the ruins. The monks came here from my own Scotland, an island, around the 6th century. The monastery was resurrected, like I said, around the 11th century. This land has seen the Norwegians, Vikings around the 7th century. There's been a lot of fighting going on right at the border between Scotland and England. Apparently, this space in Lindisfarne is right off the ocean. So it's where a lot of people migrated to. This is a sacred land. Just because there's no more priory here, monks, the energy still resides. The same thing goes with other places where there's been a lot of war, death, and dying. That energy still resides. Energy lingers. Sometimes when a person dies, that energy lingers. Maybe that spirit stays attached to the house. The energy of the monks. Prayer and worship. That energy still remains here. Energy travels with us in spirit, in land. It's downloaded. Memories, recognitions within our soul, it carries with us. And it carries within the land. First word that came to mind was sacred. I'm walking on sacred soil. I could feel it. I could hear it. It's the only thing that came to me. I was blank on the idea of the video for this. It's just walk the land. Walk the land, talk the land, feel the land. Energy just doesn't reside here. Your memories, your recollections are stored within you, creating your reality. Certain energies, feelings, emotions would be best if you let them go. That's why they do house clearings, spiritual house clearings, clearing the energy we need to do after wars taking place on land, in the world, even though we're not supposed to be fighting. Together, country to country. I don't know why it's so difficult. Shouldn't it be about power, money, and land? Who's got this space between the hours of 7 and about 1 o'clock. And then the tides rise, and then the water washes over the land. And the only way you could get back is before 1 o'clock, back to the mainlands. So it's separated by the water. But you could come in between the hours of 7 a.m. to 1. And there is a village here as well, where people stay. Spaces, not because it was an abbey, because a lot of times I didn't even know what I was stepping into. When I was in the museum garden in York, I didn't know there was an abbey there. It was torn down once again by Henry VIII. I didn't know that. Like I said, 8 times out of 10, I'm not seeking these spaces. I'm just walking across them, and pow, there I'm there. On my itinerary, I was only supposed to stay in England, probably for about... In my head, in my mind, my thoughts, I was going to stay in England for 3 weeks tops. That all changed when I got here. I wasn't attached to the itinerary, to the plan, because life is sometimes what happens to us, we're planning for it. Check it out. I'll leave some information below in the description. Vikings came, monks. These walls still remain. It's interesting how they keep them up still to this day in England. It's a beautiful thing. Because actually, it's beautiful energy that still remains, even if it was torn down. Because the light, the good energy, is much stronger than the dark energy, let's say. Love conquers all. At Lindisfarne in England. Probably about a half an hour south of the border of Scotland. Lindisfarne, the Holy Island, they call it. These names aren't given by random. Of this because of the wind, and also when I first got to the Glastonbury tour, it was so windy, there was no way I was even going to be able to do video. I couldn't even hear my thoughts. I was being blown off the top of the mountain, the tour, which means hell. But today we're present here at this priory, letting you feel the energy. Remember, every time you go into a space or around a person, feel how you feel. If it doesn't feel good, there's a reason for that. But at the same time, you could clear that energy, shift the energy in a hotel room, in a house. There are various ways to clear energy, not only within your body, mind, and spirit, but also with a home, a business, a restaurant. You need to clear it, cleanse it of the old energies that reside there if it's not serving the thriving business. If the three previous places at a restaurant failed, then you want to clear that energy even before you start a business. In a home, if you move into a new home, you want to cleanse it before you move in. Because you might not know what happened in that home. There could have been a lot of violence, could have been a lot of love. But either way, watch my video on how to clear energy, how to clear your energy, how to clear the the energy in your home, around you, within you. I teach on that. I'm an energy and spiritual healer, helping people around the world, not only just traveling to these destinations and doing one-on-one sessions, but also via Skype or phone. So here's a little peek inside, into the Priory in Lindisfarne. One more time, I'll do the little. The monks lived here, came from Iona. Vikings took over around the 7th century. It's torn down once again, but it still remains. And what's important